the best possible case scenario in pools, which was on the opposite side, Fujimura lost to John Ding, and then you beat John Ding to make it out. It's like you're in a pool with Fujimura, and you make it out on a winner's side by not playing him. That's like awesome. The best case scenario. You're like, I don't even have to play. The stress is of playing against Fujimura.
But I've been really impressed with Dual Kevin over the last, I don't know, 6 months or so. Maybe a little longer than that. As he has, I mean, he's been playing SFI the whole time, but he's really stepped it up in the game over that period. He's really gotten to be a high level competitor.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like he was in the SFL, and then since then, he's really like gotten that opportunity to travel a bit more and play a bit more. Like, he's been a really solid player for a long time, but then once he's been traveling around and showing it at these offline events, you can really see it. You're like, man, this guy is excellent.
And I think you can see too that it's really become his focus.
Yeah.
You know, previously Versus Series obviously was the focus for him, but now it is Street Fighter V, and he was one of the strongest in those games when he was playing those seriously, and that had a great competition. So you know that he has it in him to be one of the best in this game, and he's showing that now.
Yeah. See the locked and loaded here. Balrog, Rashid. You know, Smoke's been playing a lot more Balrog lately.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't watch his stream, first of all, you're missing out.
Oh, yeah.
Go check out, at least check out the highlights on YouTube. They're hilarious.
I definitely subscribe to the YouTube. Yeah,
that's the YouTube.
Easy for me to catch.
The supercut.
It's hilarious.
Yeah, that's the best case, right? Like, you don't have to tune into the whole stream. You just get, like, the 10-minute supercut of all the good moments.
Yeah.
They're so funny.
It's great.
He's been playing this character a little bit more because I think, you know, he was focused on G for a while, and then he's like, okay, I need to have a balance between the two. You know, it's like the work-life balance. During the day, you're like, you know, the president, and at night, you're a prize fighter. So you got to do a little bit of both.
That sounds exhausting.
Yeah, it does. You show up to the Oval Office with a black eye. I was like, what happened? I fell.
Regular night.
Checking with that roundhouse. That Balrog heavy kick is so good. Yeah, you just walk around and swing with that bad boy. You can't go wrong.
Been whipping, unfortunately, a couple of times here. He's caught in the corner. Smug. Harassing even still, he's not gonna get that up easily. But Dual Kevin's ready on the dash. You know, he's got reactions.
Nice, yeah, that's one thing that's important against a character like Balrog. You know, between the dash punches and stuff like that, you have to be ready for that forward movement.
Dual Kevin at range. Overhead and activate.
Yeah, you know they're gonna go for it. When Balrog players have that available, it's like you have to.
Wake up buttons and into super?
Oh,
no!
He missed it! He missed it! He tried to do
the worst bummer.
He tried to do short jab, light mixer super. That's what he was looking
for
but he instead got short jab, super. He's just trying to go for it.
Yeah.
Unfortunate there. Dual Kevin had the right idea.
Yeah. Would have worked. So Dual Kevin now pressuring. Eagle's on over.
Wow. Low medium kick, Eagle Spike just hit confirm?
He just. Or he was right. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. That was crazy. The medium didn't hit. Medium punch.
Okay. Out of there is Smug. But Dual Kevin immediately with the stand short.
Yeah, nice counter hit combo too. The medium punch.
Lovely stuff right on through. And the linkage.
Yeah, we saw Brian F. trying to do that against John Takeuchi, but couldn't quite get the timing.
Out of there yet again. Isar floats away. Dual Kevin buttons in almost every situation there.
Looks for the crush on that crouching heavy punch. Doesn't find it. What a buffer.
Mm-hmm. Again, stand short. Here's Kevin. He's almost got another trigger. If he can get a roll or something.
Yeah, the roll kick activate. For that crouching
heavy punch. Wow. What? He dashed almost through the crouching medium kick. It was like almost graphically directly through it.
Yeah, I swear he just dashed clean through it. It was like he just parried it out of the way. In like the 2D space somehow, made it past it, and then got the throw. And if you're Dual Kevin, you are not teching there. You're not ready for that dash. He dashed through your move.
Yeah.
In fact, he was probably like, he saw the dash and was like, oh, I'm going to hit him with my crouching medium kick.
He's probably buffering a button.
Yeah, he's like, let me buffer it. Wait, what? I'm dead.
He's still processing it.
Yeah, it's right now he's computing. He's like, excuse me? You did what now? Dash through where?
In both of those rounds, he definitely almost took it. Right, in the first round,
where
he could have had to confirm into super, just screwed it up. In the second one there, where somehow medium kick didn't hit.
Yeah, this could easily have been two straight rounds Dual Kevin.
100%.
Which is a bad feeling, because it's two straight rounds Smug, right? So if you're Dual Kevin, you're like, man, the worst possible scenario. Because now you have to like rely on Smug, you know, not just beating you up in these next games.
On the other hand, you can think of it as, look, hey, I almost won. Like, I don't need to really change up that much, just maybe hit my execution better.
Yeah, he's definitely on the right track. Neutral jump setup. Very strong against characters with weak wake-up options. It's good against a lot of characters.
Sure.
Little punish on the dash straight with the crouching line kick.
Get it while you can. Trigger's ready whenever.
Overhead. You're going to go for it. When they have V-trigger available, I mean, overhead into V-trigger is plus 8 on block. So if it hits, you get a combo. If it's blocked, I mean, you're only plus 8.
No big deal.
Counter hit a little too far.
Yeah, unfortunately. He definitely tried. Oh, this could too. Directly. He's not taking any risks at all.
Yeah.
He saw what happened in the last couple rounds. No risks. Seal the deal.
Yeah, that was a good choice. Just take what you can get. Don't try any EX and anything fancy to try to get the kill. Just take the critical R. Easy kill. Easy round.
Oh, yeah. Trading buttons here. Wow, okay.
Yeah, try for that early jump heavy punch again, but Smug anti-air beat it out. Walk
really
up, trade on the down jump.
That space that's about a third of the screen between them. A lot of the action going on right there. Advantage, of course, as Smug moves in. Oh, wow, okay, Fierce beat it.
Yeah, that was huge. That jumping heavy punch is a big button. And very,
Sakura,
especially...
Sakura SF4 from the grave.
Yeah, especially like early jump Fierce, like, you have to be super ready.
Mm-hmm.
Stun?
No, hold on
yeah,
a second.
Yeah, very close.
Hold on. Duel Kevin. So, look, he almost won the first game 2-0 in rounds. He did win the second game 2-0 in rounds.
Yeah.
He's playing very well.
And that's the thing, too. It's like, in that kind of a scenario, if you're Smug, you know, he wakes up 3-frame button there. I don't blame him. You know, you got to try to do something in that scenario. You could try to block in V-reversal. You don't have that much health. Like, you got to do something. And so he tried, you know, bet it all in the 3-frame, hoping he could hit. He had V-trigger to activate and get a combo after standing reset, try to get a situation that works out for you. I don't blame him.
Smug making sure his breathing is right.
Round one. Probably the last thing on his mind.
He's never thought about
the
it.
The furthest thing. He's been like, for his whole life, his breathing's been just dandy.
Yeah. Or not. He just hasn't even noticed.
Yeah. Man, that crouching Fierce buffer. That is a scary move. It just, it's so good. It either crushes, you can cancel it.
Smug trying to meet him air to air.
Yeah, maybe.
In any case, Duel Kevin trying to slowly back Smug up. Mostly working out here. Fierce Mixer has the anti-air. Now he's got the full-on corner control. There is a trigger. Hold on, though. May not get an action.
Yeah, I love that EX Whirlwind Shot not canceled, too. It's much harder to react to. I feel like if you're not canceling it off a button, that was great. He's been hit overhead so many times that I like Smug with the fake out.
Okay, wake up button right there in a risky spot for it.
The side switch, Duel Kevin. He's blocked a couple of left rights in his life.
Duel Kevin just backing off here. He's got it. It's his turn. Smug knows it.
Oh my, that was a great choice. With the Whirlwind to protect you, I don't mind going for the roundhouse. It's a great throw bait.
Yeah.
It's only minus 4 anyway, and with the Whirlwind there, you know, if he does dash punch, he's getting eaten up.
Totally fine. So, match point, Duel Kevin. He continues to just blitz on through. Each of these rounds, he's gotten the corner. Each of these rounds, he's gotten close to stun. He's going to get there again. Smug blocks it out. Okay, lovely Fierce.
All right, low activate. Doesn't go for that overhead. It's been so successful. The jump over, one hit for Duel Kevin.
Look
here.
Look at this.
He's working on chip.
Critical
R is a big threat now. Smug needs a lot.
Smug took no... I'm sorry, Kevin took no risks on that one.
Yeah, no problem.
Out of there.
V-reversal's out. Oh, the smash miss. The
that
crush.
Should be it.
Duel Kevin over Smug and top 96 cleans it up 2-1. And he has got to feel great about that one. That first game was close, but after that, Duel Kevin really wrapped it up.
Yeah, he won 6 straight rounds.
Beat.